bathroom too. What's to be done?
It will blow over, sir. Her ladyship intends taking the children with her, and the cook is also living.
Oh. Well, I'll lunch at the Hermitage with Mr. Levin. Who's that?
The new English governess.
Oh. No more French lessons.
Mademoiselle Roland was dismissed last night. Her ladyship found the letter.
The letter?
Your letter to Mademoiselle Roland.
Saved. We're saved. My sister Anna is arriving from St. Petersburg today.
Good day, Your Excellency.
Good day.
Ah, you won. Charming.
Thank you.
Ah, mes hommages, votre excellence.
Good day, Albert. Is my table free?
Would you like your private room, Excellence?
No, no. I'm lunching with a gentleman.
Oh, yes. Monsieur Levine. He's here already. Vodka?
Yes.
Très bien.
Constantine! I'm afraid I've kept you waiting.
Trouble at home.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Let's go in. Have you had your vodka?
Yes, thanks.
Vodka for me,
have another. Two vodkas.
Well, what are we going to eat?
Oysters?
I want your word of honor, Albert.
Are they fresh?
Oh, I arrived only yesterday.
Care for oysters, Levin?
Well, if I can't have my usual cabbage soup.
You country bumpkin. Forget the manure heaps.
Your table, votre excellence.
You sit there, Constantine?
Yes.
I've had a terrible time. You know how I adore my wife. I'd no more do anything to hurt Dolly than...
I know.
Well, that's what's so awful. The French governess. I know. It shouldn't have been the French governess. But as I say, my wife's taken so much to heart, insisting on a separation and so on. Poor Dolly. Women, my boy, they're the pivot. You marry, you love each other, time goes by, and all of a sudden you find yourself snatching at somebody else.
That's what I can't understand. Any more than I can understand how after a delicious meal like this I could possibly go out to the baker's and snatch a roll.
Sometimes a roll smells so nice you can't resist it.
Excuse me, I've never seen a fallen woman that was charming. They're all like that painted French girl at the counter with her dyed hair. They're all the same, and I have a loathing for them.
But the Magdalene?
Oh, stop it, please. Christ would never have used those words if he'd known they were going to be abused. People quote them more than anything else in the whole gospel.
All right, preacher, all right. Now let's talk about you and your affairs. Have you seen Kitty?
No, not yet. I wanted to see you first. You see, you're her brother-in-law, you ought to know. Tell me, have I got a chance?
My wife thinks so.
She does?
She says you two are bound to marry. And she's not often wrong in that sort of thing.
I've always had the greatest admiration for Dolly. You see, my feelings for Kitty are...
Oh, I think I ought to tell you. You have a rival, Count Vronsky.
Vronsky?
One of our Moscow eligibles. Handsome, intelligent, frightfully rich...
Well, I suppose
and...
I'm the country bumpkin with manure on his boots.
Rubbish. You have your own qualities, my dear Constantine. But I do advise you to talk to Kitty.
Everything all right, Excellence? What is it?
Take your arm and lay hands off me! Leave me alone!
You don't you dare. My brother.
What?
It's my brother, Nikolai.
Count of old Moscow.
Help you!
Nikolai!
Constantine, my dove, my darling big brother.
He must be mad in front of all Moscow.
I'm not mad, I'm drunk. Well, if it isn't little Prince Oblonsky.
Come along, Nikolai, I'll take you home.
But I don't want to go home.
still thinking of your son?
Yes, I'm afraid I was. I was wondering what he was doing at just this minute. Coming back from his walk, I think, with poor Marietta panting behind him. Would you like to see his picture?
I'd love to.
There he is.
He's charming.
Isn't he?
You know, he's a little like your husband, but what is nice about him, he gets from you. Now, I never know what my son may be doing. Perhaps it's just as well.
Oh, why, Countess?
Have a look at those eyes, my dear, and perhaps you'll understand what I mean.
He's very handsome.
Princess, I wouldn't have failed to pay you my respects today, but I can only stay for a moment. I promised to meet my mother at the station.
So the Countess is deserting her beloved St. Petersburg.
She can no longer bear to be away from her beloved Moscow. She'll feel like that for about a week. My mother maintains that traveling kills her, but she spends half her life in trains. Besides, this time it's at my request she's coming. Thank you.
Kitty, my dear child, what are you doing? I'm sure Count Vronsky hates cream.
Oh, I'm sorry,
I'm going to like it.
Constantine Dmitrievich?
Perhaps a little.
Have you enough sugar?
Oh, yes, thanks. Kitty, I want to tell you why I ran away from Moscow last year, why I've come back again today.
I'm afraid, Constantine Dmitrievich.
Afraid? What of?
Of hurting you.
Then perhaps it would be better if I didn't tell you why I came back again today.
Kitty couldn't wish for a better husband. He's handsome, rich, brilliant.
Too brilliant. I should prefer that other one over there. He's a good fellow.
My dear, you've no idea what women like.
Nor have they, unfortunately.
Constantine Dmitrievich. I like you. I like you very much indeed. But it's impossible. Forgive me.
Greetings, my dear Count.
Ah, greetings.
Who are you meeting?
Just my mother. You?
My sister, Anna.
Ah, Madame Karenina.
Yes. Do you know her?
No, I don't believe I do.
You must at least know my famous brother-in-law, Alexei Alexandrovich.
By reputation and by sight, like all our great statesmen. A walking encyclopedia, they say.
Oh, chiefly a colossal bore.
If I can find my brother.
Anushka, look after my bag.
Yes, madam.
Oh, here you are you? So you got my telegram?
Indeed. Did you have a good journey?
Excellent. I had a charming companion. Well, my dear, and how are you?
Wonderful.
Ah, good, good. They tell me you've started a new love affair.
I don't know what you're referring to, madam.
Did you find your brother?
No.
Oh, your brother is here, madame. I'm afraid you don't know me.
Yes, I do. Your mother and I have been talking about you nearly all the way.
We've been discussing our sons.
That must have bored you considerably.
What else do you think mothers talk about? Well, Countess, I'd come to the end of all my story. Had the journey lasted much longer, I would have had nothing more to tell you.
Alexei, go and find Anna Arkadyevna's brother.
Sir.
Oblonsky! Oblonsky! Here!
Anna!
Stepan! How are you, dear?
Terrible. I'll tell you about it. I've been counting on you.
Are you serious?
Ganger, he was crushed.
Oh, let's go. I hate accidents.
Come away. Don't upset yourself.
What a dreadful day. On the very day that I arrive in Moscow, I feel it's a bad omen.
What nonsense. You're here. That's the main thing. You don't know how I'm depending on you.
Have you known Count Vronsky long?
Oh, for some time. We think he's going to marry Kitty.
Really? Well, now let's talk about yourself. I got your letter and here I am. But Stepan, why did you put yourself in such a situation? Marriage is a sacred thing, you know.
Yes.
If I were Dolly, I would not forgive you.
But I love Dolly.
The carriage has just returned from the station with Anna Arkadyevna. Oh. What shall I do with the children?
Well, it's too late now to leave tonight. Let me help you. You'd better get them off to bed.
I'm afraid they won't go until they have seen their aunt.
All right. All right, then.
Darling, I'm so glad to see you. Oh. My poor darling. He told me everything. I can't tell you how sorry I feel for you. No. I'm not going to defend him. We must talk it over and see what can be done.
There's nothing to be done. The worst of it is I cannot leave him because of the children, and I can't live with him after what has happened. I was a perfect fool. I knew absolutely nothing. For 8 years, I believed that I was the only woman he ever loved.
I think I know how men like Stepan look at these things. In their hearts, they despise these women. Oh, yes, they do. And they draw a line between them and their families.
Yes. But he's kissed her.
I know. He's made you suffer horribly. And yet I can't help feeling sorry for him, too. Dolly, he loves you, really. Do see him. He's so unhappy.
Do you really think that he's unhappy?
Yes.
Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses.
Go to her, Stepan.
All the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again.
Katya! Tanya! Miss Hull, I think the children can go to bed now.
Yes, Your Ladyship.
But, old Tanner, we haven't seen you yet.
Ivan!
Well,
everything's going to be all right.
What is it, Kitty?
How beautiful you look, Anna.
Oh.
Aunt Anna, are you going to the ball? Oh, do show us your dress.
I will as soon as you're in bed.
Promise?
Promise.
Promise?
Promise. When is the ball?
Tomorrow, at the Meskovs. It's going to be the most wonderful ball. One of those where you always enjoy yourself.
Come along, yes. Children. Don't bother her ladyship.
Thank you, darling.
You too, Ivan. What? Come along, Katya.
There we are.
Kitty, I know why you want me to go to the ball. You want everyone to share in your happiness. I met Captain Vronsky at the station, you know.
Was he there? But what has Stepan been telling you?
The whole story. His mother says he's quite a hero. But of course, mothers are prejudiced.
What a pity your husband couldn't come.
Oh, I can't imagine Alexei Alexandrovich Karenin dancing. He'd be quite lost without state papers in his hand.
Mom! All right, children, you can go to bed now. My wife. The finest, the sweetest, the kindest wife a man could ever wish for.
Anna, darling dear, I'm so glad.
Good night,
darling. Good night, darling.
Good night,
darling.
Good night, darling.
All right, children. You can say good night to your father now.
Good night, little one. Good night. Good night. Good night. Off to bed. Good little children. There we are.
Don't forget your promise, Aunt Alice.
No, I won't, my darling. Now, I must hurry. I haven't even unpacked yet.
Tell His Excellency I just want to have a word with him. I'll wait here.
Do I disturb you? I just wanted to know if you're going to join us at the club dinner we're arranging for Wednesday night.
It is nice of you, but you shouldn't have gone out of your way. We should have met anyway at the Meskov's ball.
Of course. But then I wasn't sure you were going.
Anna Cardium.
Oh, yes, it's wonderful.
Kitty, the happiness in your eyes is lovelier than any dress.
My dear Anna, darling.
Charming evening, isn't it?
Yes, indeed, my dear.
Will you forgive me? Anna Arkadyevna.
Good evening, Carl.
How delightful to see you again in Moscow. You can't refuse me this poker, can you?
My dear Korzynski, you know very well I never dance unless I can help it.
You can't today. You're much too beautiful.
In that case, let us dance.
I'm so sorry, Kitty. I hadn't seen you. Would you care to dance?
With pleasure, Count.
Go and get it attended to, child.
Yes. Yes, perhaps I should. Thank you.
Two hunters sent over from Ireland, but one died.
Oh.
I think it was the wrong time of year. It was autumn, and they're difficult to acclimatize.
It should have been the spring, of course.
Yes, it should have been the spring.
Or the summer.
Or the summer.
Ladies and gentlemen, kindly take your partners for the polonaise.
Will you do me the honor of dancing with me?
I'm sorry, but I promised it to Count Bronski.
Mm-hmm.
Are you sure? The mistake couldn't possibly have been his.
I must have mixed them up. How stupid of me.
Would you care to dance?
Oh, do you mind if I don't? It's my shoe. It's been hurting all evening. And...
oh, I'm so sorry. It must be torture.
Yes.
Be ridiculous, child. You can't possibly leave before supper.
I'm tired, Mother. I'd rather go home.
But you scarcely danced at all. I thought Count Bronski had signed your card for the mazurka.
Grigori will take me home.
Don't catch cold and go straight to bed.
Is she not feeling well?
She's upset. Whatever came over that young man behaving like that?
I told you. I always preferred the other one, my dear. Let's go into supper so that her departure is not noticed.
We often do go to the races.
I haven't missed a military cup since I was a boy. How beautiful your dress is.
Well, Anna Arkadyevna, are you not coming in to supper?
No, thank you, Countess. I'm leaving in the morning, and I think I should rest before my journey.
Must you really go?
I'm afraid so. But you know, I've danced more tonight than I generally do during a whole winter in St. Petersburg. So will you forgive me? It's been a charming evening.
Should have stayed a few days more. The house is not the same without you.
I must go, darling. I really must.
Kitty is not very well. She sent her maid to say goodbye for her.
You know, it's because of Kitty that I'm going. She was so happy, and she expected so much from this ball, and I spoiled the evening for her.
Yes, Captain Vronsky danced a lot with you.
Yes, but I'm really not to blame. Or perhaps I am. A little. But it was quite unintentional.
You said that just like Stepan.
Oh, no, I'm not like Stepan. Oh, dear. I'm going away having made an enemy of Kitty, and I'm so fond of her. You will make it all right with her, won't you, Dolly? Tell her that I hope they'll soon be married and that she'll be very happy. Now, where is Stepan? I shall miss my train.
Stepan!
Coming, coming. Anna, you're a marvel. Up fresh and early after such a late night. Don't know how you manage it. You dance like a debutante. Do you remember the hearts we used to break together in the old days? Oh, right. I don't know what I'm talking about. Is everything loaded up?
Yes, Excellency.
Good, then we better be going.
Goodbye, darling.
Goodbye, Anna.
I shall never forget what you've done for me. Remember that I love you and always will, whatever happens.
Now the wings get going.
Not very well. What station is this?
Clin, madame. A few minutes to take in water.
Thank you. I'm going out for a breath of air.
Thank you.
Petersburg. Have you been recalled?
You know I'm going there to be where you are. Because I cannot do otherwise. I'm sorry if what I've just said displeases you.
I hope you will forget it. As I shall forget it.
Not a word, not a gesture of yours shall I ever forget. Nor can I.
Kind, devoted husband you have, just as in the old days, burning with desire to see you, my dear. Not too bad a night?
How is Sergei?
Is that all the reward I get for my devotion? He's quite well, quite well. I let him come to see you. He's in the cabin.
Oh.
Did you have a good night, madame?
Yes, yes, thank you. Very good. Come, Francis.
I believe I have the honor of your acquaintance. It seems, my dear, you went with the mother and came back with the son. You're back from leave, no doubt. I'm very flattered you found so little in Moscow to retain.
I hope to have the honor of calling on you.
Delighted. We receive on Thursdays. I was very lucky to be able to come. I'm snowed under with work at the moment. My dear, I'm expected at the ministry. Important conference. I'll see you at dinner. I'll try not to be late. To the ministry.
Turn over, please.
Poor darling. She's dying of shame. Must he do that?
He insists on a complete examination, my dear.
No young girl should be completely examined. It's indecent.
I know what's wrong with her, Mama. It's nothing that medicine will cure. Just leave me alone with her for a moment.
Well, Doctor?
Do you happen to know if the Yansky Bridge has been repaired yet, or is it necessary to go around?
I do not, sir.
Is it anything serious?
Oh, yes.
There's no...
No, nothing to worry about. A little anemia. She is suffering from nervous depression. Perhaps crossed in some little love affair. Good food and fresh air are all she needs. There'll be no trace of it left in the spring. Did you say the bridge was open? Did you?
Do you think I don't know? Believe me, it's not worth breaking your heart about. We've all been through this sort of thing.
Oh, for heaven's sake, don't sympathize with me. It drives me mad. You think I'm breaking my heart over a man who doesn't love me. You, my sister,
Kitty.
I'm not like you, swallowing your pride and going back to a man who's betrayed you with another woman. Oh, darling. I'm so unhappy.
You must tell me everything. Did Konstantin Levin speak to you?
Yes, but I'm so unhappy.
Where were your thoughts just then?
I confess to my shame, still at the ministry. This report worries me. I'm playing a strong hand in denouncing the negligence of our administration. Nevertheless, the case is quite clear. I've tabled a motion before the Imperial Council. This motion, of course, will be different for each province. And the Council... And you? What are you thinking of?
Nothing. I'm afraid I was daydreaming.
Forgive me, I was beginning to bore you. I must deal with my tiresome papers. Oh, you're going out this evening?
Had you forgotten? You'd promised to take me to the opera.
Of course. But I'm terribly sorry I shan't be able to go. Natalia, sharing your box?
Yes, don't worry, I shall not be alone. Count Vronsky will be there too. And dear Betsy.
That's splendid. Then I don't need to have a bad conscience.
I could stay if you wished.
Hmm? No, no, my dear. Russia's affairs don't require both of us to be bored. Go and enjoy your evening.
I have known for some time that Russia can do without me. But I thought perhaps if you... Alexei Alexandrovich.
Come in.
Good evening, Your Excellency.
Ah, you've got everything?
Everything, Excellency.
Good evening, Fyodor.
Good evening, Madame.
Anna?
Yes?
Give my love to Natalia.
Not in bed yet, Sergei?
But he said I could, Mother.
Yes, but not all night.
No, Mother, but I'm winning now, you see.
Oh, I see. I'm going to the opera, darling, and I've come to kiss you goodnight.
Good night, Mother. You shouldn't have hugged me. I didn't see that. I was kissing Mother. Now I'm going to take you.
Would you like me to stay and play your draft?
Oh, no, you always beat me. The king!
Here's the table. Now we can indulge in our favorite vice. Put it here.
No, I'm a friend of Anna's. Yes, yes, so I can say this. Since her return from Moscow, I find her very changed. There's something strange about her.
The change may be due to the fact that she has a shadow following her.
A shadow?
The shadow of Count Vronsky.
What of that? It was a fairy tale by Grimm about a man without a shadow. I seem to recall it was taken from him as a punishment.
That would be extremely dull for a woman to be without one.
Ah, but women with shadows usually come to a bad end.
Your tongue's too sharp, my dear. It'll cut you one day. Anna's an adorable creature.
Oh, I'm not blaming her.
And because nobody follows us like a shadow, it doesn't give us the right to judge others. Anna, my dear. You've come just in time. How are you, Natalia? Good evening, Countess. We were talking about you.
Perhaps I've come too early, then. Not at all. We were saying you were the loveliest woman at the opera tonight.
Lydia is always so generous.
And truthful. Yes, there's quite the word she's
getting. Good evening, dear Count.
Thank you.
Jesus. My dear Vronsky, how nice to see you. You well?
Yes, and you?
I thought you hated opera.
For once, I wish to be elegantly bored like other people.
Weren't you in Anna Arkadyevna's box?
Yes.
You can't have been too bored, then.
Anna, my dear. Now, my friends, we mustn't keep the spirits waiting. Anna, will you join us?
Anna, dear.
We are going to try and communicate with the soul of a woman who was famous for her love affairs.
No, thank you, really.
Madame Karenina is a free thinker. She doesn't believe in such things.
On the contrary, I'm horribly superstitious. I even believe in dreams. For some time now, I've had a nightmare, which terrifies me. Always the same one.
So have I. I dream every night of birds. Tiny little fragile creatures. The dream changes. And I am one of the little birds. Someone takes me between his two fingers and stifles me.
It must be Hercules himself.
My nightmare is less poetic. I see a little old man with a white beard, dressed in rags and carrying a hammer. He strikes on something with a piece of iron, and I hear a clanging noise. I don't know why, but this image is closely bound up with the idea of my death.
It's rather uncanny, isn't it?
Everybody, let's stop talking. Put your hands on the table.
Finger to finger.
There we are.
No, General, your fingers must touch.
Together.
So, now let's concentrate. Put out the lights.
Oh.
The vibrations are very strong tonight. Who's to ask the questions?
But you, of course, my dear. Spirits are your guests.
This must end.
Tell me what you want me to do.
If you love me,
as you say you do. Give me back my peace.
I know no peace. And I cannot give it back to you. I see none in the future, either for you or for me. I see nothing ahead of us but sorrow and despair. Unless it be happiness. Such happiness. Is it quite hopeless?
For my sake, never speak to me like that again. Let us be friends.
The princess has had the lights put out as she is communicating with the spirits.
Oh. Good.
We can never be friends. You know that. I ask for nothing but the right to suffer and to hope as in this moment. But even if that is impossible, order me to go and I will.
No, I cannot do that.
History says you were a great lover. Can you reveal to us, is love worthwhile?
Not in bed yet? What a surprise. It is late, Alexei Alexandrovich.
I want to speak to you, Anna.
Speak to me? What about? Well, let us talk if we must. But it is late and I would rather go to sleep.
Assuming that questions relating to feelings are matters of conscience, into which I have no right to probe, it is still my duty as head of the family to guide you.
What are you talking about?
Anna, you are not yourself this evening.
Alexei Alexandrovich, I don't understand you.
I feel that an indiscretion such as you were guilty of tonight may lead people to talk about you.
Indiscretion? Tonight?
I went to Princess Betsy's house this evening to take you home. I noticed, or rather it was forced upon my notice, that your conversation with Count Bronski attracted considerable attention.
Isn't that typical of you? You don't like me to enjoy myself and you don't like me to be bored. I was not bored this evening. Is that what troubles you? Please don't crack your fingers. You know how much I dislike it.
Really, I think you're most inconsiderate. To cause me this stupid anxiety just when I have the greatest need of all my mental powers and should be concentrating on important affairs.
Please let me finish undressing.
It's my duty to remind you of your obligations. Our lives are united by God. That bond can only be broken by a crime. Such a crime brings its own punishment.
I really don't know what crime you are talking about, and I'm dreadfully sleepy.
I love you. I consider jealousy to be a degrading sentiment. But there are certain laws of propriety which cannot be broken without the gravest consequences. Have you no explanation?
There is nothing to explain, except that I am falling asleep.
Thank you.
Mahutin broke his back.
Oh, how terrible.
It's sheer slaughter. Steeple chasing would be absolutely forbidden.
Ready.
Here?
What if he is? I don't think of him. For me, he doesn't exist anymore.
Why should we have to whisper?
What does it matter? The only thing that matters to me in the world is your love.
I want to take you away from here. Forget everything but your happiness.
You are my happiness.
Hello, Anna. How are you, Marcel? I only arrived yesterday, just in time to witness your triumph.
We'll see.
Were you there for the last race? They went over like ninepins. Prince Mahotin hurt himself badly. Those jumps are suicidal. Mind you don't break your neck.
I'll take care of myself. I must go now.
Princess Betsy is waiting in her box. Shall we join her?
So Mahotin came off.
Aye, at the open ditch. It is a divil of a leap. You'll have to be careful there. Oh, by the way, your brother the Colonel was asking for you a minute ago. Oh, there he's over yonder.
You're never to be found. Where do you hide? Did you get my note?
Yes, I did. But I don't know what you're worrying about.
It's not me, it's Mama. She's heard that you refused an appointment in Tashkent.
That's my business.
Quiet. Quiet. But I do agree with her that you should think over carefully what you're doing. After all, you have a career.
My career concerns me alone.
Have it your own way. Oh, I just wanted to give you this note from Mama. But I should read it after the race. I don't want it to upset you. Good night.
Thank you.
Anna, dear, you're looking worried. Those falls have frightened you.
I think they have a little.
I can quite understand that. If I had someone of my family, well, someone I was fond of amongst the young officers, I'd be frightened to death.
Don't distress yourself, dear Countess. You'll never be frightened to death. You'll never be fond enough of anyone.
Now, take it easy. And remember this, when you come to a jump, don't urge her on. And don't hold her back. Oh, just let her have her head. Ah, she's a great mare now.
And what do you think about these races, Mr. Karenin? That last race was nothing but a massacre.
Danger, my dear ladies, is a necessary part of these officers' races. Don't forget the men who are riding today are soldiers. Danger is part of their training.
Yes, but danger when it serves a purpose.
They're just going to give the signal for the start. I find it rather fascinating myself. If I'd been a Roman, how I should have loved those gladiators. All that blood.
The grey?
Yes.
That's Kozalev. Come on, Kozalev.
Watch this jump.
Oh, oh. Who's down? It's Kozalev. The grey is hot.
No, Bronski?
Isn't he going beautiful?
He's coming up.
Oh.
Bronski!
Ball!
Bronski?
Yes, in front.
Come on, Alexei.
Give it a hand!
Come on, come on, come on.
No.
Come
can go if you wish. Take my arm, Anna. We will go.
Count Vronsky is unhurt. The horse is going to be destroyed.
For the third time, I offer you my arm.
I brought Anna here. I'll take her back.
I'm sorry, Princess. I can see that Anna is not well. I will take her home myself.
Poor child. How well I understand her.
I'm obliged to inform you that your conduct today has been extremely improper. I have already asked you to conduct yourself in public in such a way as to give no occasion for the gossip of evil tongues. Such a scene makes me feel there may be truth in such gossip. Perhaps I am mistaken.
No, you are not mistaken. I'm listening to you and thinking of him. I love him. I'm afraid of you and I hate you. Do what you like with me.
I very much regret to have kept you waiting.
Not at all, not at all.
Come in, please. Would you sit down? Oh. Forgive me. These clerks, you know. Now, what can I do for you?
Before I begin speaking of my case, I must insist that the matter is strictly private.
Well, I should not be a lawyer unless I could keep secrets, Excellency.
You know who I am.
Yes, I know who you are. And I know the good work you are doing for Russia.
I have the misfortune to be a deceived husband. I wish to break off relations legally with my wife, that is, to be divorced, in such a way as to separate my son from his mother.
Such feelings are by no means unusual in the earlier stages, but I often find my client show a subsequent readiness to say, shall we say, come to terms. You're certain there's no question of a reconciliation?
No, no, she's guilty. She must be punished.
Good. And you're quite determined on the question of custody?
I cannot let her profit by her guilt.
Quite so. Quite so. According to our laws, divorce is possible in the following cases and only in the following cases. Let them wait.
Yes, the lady.
Let her wait. Firstly, physical defects in either party. Secondly, 5 years' absence without news. Thirdly, adultery duly established. Am I right in thinking we are concerned with the last case?
Yes.
Good. Here, a subdivision has to be made. Adultery by one of the married persons and acknowledged by the guilty party, or flagrante delicto. Could you possibly arrange for one of you to be caught in the act?
In my position, I must avoid all public scandal.
Then, Excellency, we must have proof.
What proof?
Letters, for example. Yes, but remember, the ecclesiastic courts who judge these sorts of affairs have a great liking for details. I must have letters with all details. I'm so sorry, but my house is infested with moths. Do you have the same trouble? Letters with all details.
What are you doing?
I'm looking for some letters.
What letters?
have no right.
We've both assumed rights that are not ours. You despise me, don't you? A deceived husband is a bad part. Difficult to act with dignity.
What are you going to do with those letters?
I shall divorce you and obtain the custody of Sergei.
You cannot take Sergei from me.
With these letters, I can.
You cannot take him from me. You don't love him as I do. He's mine. I couldn't bear it.
And me? Has anyone ever asked if I can bear it? Has anyone ever? My deserted house. Alone. My misery. My shame.
I never wished to hurt you. Some things are stronger than we are. I cannot help myself. I cannot change anything that has happened. You are a good man. You could not be so cruel as to take my son from me. Alexei, spare me my love for him. His love for me.
In the name of love, people think they can do anything. Love has every right. Did you ask yourself even once if I loved you?
What kind of love did you ever give me?
Have I failed in my duty towards you?
Duty? That's all you ever saw in me. Another duty. Together with your duty to the state, your duty to society, your duty to others. That is not love.
I cannot understand you. I'm leaving for Moscow. I shall never return here. In the meantime, I must insist on the preservation of appearances, at any rate until I've taken the necessary steps to vindicate my honor, which I shall communicate to you.
But Sergei, what will you do with Sergei?
My lawyer will answer that question.
You cannot torture me like this. Please leave me, Sergei. Please.
Just leaving for the country. You used to have told us that you were in Moscow.
I'm sorry, I was busy. I had no time.
And how is my dear Anne?
Quite well, thank you.
You must bring her to stay with us in the country.
Yes. When can you come?
I'm sorry, I cannot come.
What do you mean? Why?
I cannot come because the family relationship which has hitherto existed between us is about to be severed. I am placed under the painful necessity of taking proceedings for divorce.
But what has she done?
Not Anna.
You must be mistaken.
It's difficult to be mistaken when your wife tells you herself that 8 years of married life and her son come for nothing and that she wants to start life all over again. I thank you for your sympathy. It is time for me to go.
No, wait. You must take pity on her. You must forgive her.
I cannot forgive. I don't want to forgive. I consider it unjust to forgive.
Madame is in the garden by the river, Count Vronsky.
Thank you. Don't bother, I'll find her myself.
This way, please.
After considering the painful situation in which you have placed me, I am prepared to offer you the following alternatives. Either a divorce, which means you would have to give up your child, or the preservation of the status quo, on the strict understanding that you're never seen openly with your lover. You see the sort of man he is. Provided society and the servants see nothing wrong, he doesn't mind.
But he offers you divorce. Divorce and you're in agony. Now I hope you'll let me arrange and plan our life.
You don't understand. I should have to leave Sergei.
Yes, my darling, I do, but I can't bear to see you so humiliated.
I am not humiliated. How can I be when I have your love? Alexei, you were late today. I waited and waited for you. Where have you been? What detained you? Who detained you?
Anna, don't quarrel with me.
No. No, I won't. I won't be jealous. Of course you couldn't come any sooner. I don't know why. Yes, I do. Lydia told me where you were last night.
Yes, at Prince Petrov's. And it was all quite intolerable.
Men enjoy that sort of thing. You didn't? Oh. I suppose Therese wasn't there.
No, of course she wasn't there. But they had a ridiculous Swedish swimming instructors.
Swimming instructor? Did she swim? Why did she swim? What did you wear?
Anna, you know that there isn't a thought in my mind or heart that doesn't concern you.
Don't be angry.
I'm not angry. I cannot understand him. How can he put up with such a situation?
He understands nothing and he feels nothing. Could a man with any feeling live in the same house as he did for months with his unfaithful wife? Talk to her. Call her my dear, Anna ma chère. If I'd been in his place, I would have torn to pieces a wife like me. I wouldn't have called her Anna ma chère. Oh, I know he's good. I'm not worth his little finger.
Anna, you know the answer to all this.
Divorce. But I'm not only thinking of Sergei. I'm thinking of you. People will say he ruined his career for her.
What do I care what people say?
But you will. And what shall I do one day when you look at me? Bored, unhappy. Oh, it would be better to be dead.
Don't say such things.
There is nothing I can say that would alter your decision to resign?
No, sir.
At ease. Forget my rank for a moment. We've known each other for a long time. We still, I hope, are friends.
Of course.
Men like you are needed.
By whom?
By Russia and by society.
I'm sure that Russian society can manage without me.
How can I put it to you? You see, suppose you are carrying a burden and you want your hands free. You strap the burden to your back, which is like marriage. Without marriage, you're dragging the burden and your hands are full.
You have never loved.
I'm married.
I understand perfectly what I'm doing.
I shall hand your resignation to His Majesty.
But surely her husband knows. He must know.
Good evening. We are talking of Liza Markalova.
Ah, is she here, Liza Markalova?
Opposite.
Oh, yes. Still as beautiful as ever.
And she has that fatal blend of innocence and corruption.
Corruption?
Oh, I say it with admiration, my dear. It's my tribute to a woman who can keep a husband and a lover in perfect accord with each other for 10 years.
The golden rule being that hypocrisies must never be outraged.
What is the meaning of this strange conversation?
Strange? A triangle is always a favorite topic.
Is it?
Liza Markalova has behaved very sensibly. Her ménage has become almost respectable. Many young people are throwing their bonnets over the windmill. But there are ways and ways of doing it.
Are there?
She has obeyed the rules. She laid down no challenge to society, so none has ever been taken up. She avoided catastrophe.
But remains a subject of conversation.
A light subject, not a tragic one. You see, one can take a thing too seriously and make a kind of tragedy out of it. Or one can treat it quite simply and lightheartedly. Do you know, my dear, I believe you're rather inclined to the tragic side.
Yes. Yes, perhaps I am. Forgive me. Shall I see you later?
What is it, Anna? What's the matter?
Oh, my darling. Let us go away.
We shall go, dearest. I shall have my release from the army in a month or so. Then we shall go. What have they been saying to distress you?
Oh, nothing. Nothing, really. But it's as if we were part of their own hypocrisy. So cheap. So contemptible.
Attendant! Quick. And this, gentlemen, is my considered opinion on the matter.
I think you'll agree that our friend has done valuable work, very valuable. And
an urgent telegram, Excellency.
And that his report, as far as it goes, is well documented.
Excuse me.
Nevertheless, before we on this commission go further, I think we should take up the points which he merely touches. Now, what I am about to propose is no less than a radical and fundamental change in the existing law. I'll take a night train to Petersburg. Such proposals will no doubt cause a considerable storm. Nevertheless, I am prepared to face it.
Gentlemen, let us hear what His Excellency Alexei Alexandrovich Karenin proposes upon this matter.
I'm sure Alexei will come. I mean Alexei Alexandrovich Karenin. Strange. Terrible that they should both have the same name.
Good morning, Your Excellency.
How is your mistress?
They say there is little hope, Your Excellency. The child was stillborn.
Thank God you've come, Your Excellency. She's talked of nothing but you since yesterday. I'm afraid there's not much hope.
Anything for me?
Yes, Your Excellency. The rest has been forwarded to Moscow as usual, Your Excellency.
Mm-hmm.
to me. Anna Arkadyevna, look. He has come. He's here. Who are you? What are you doing here?
Dr. Leveillé.
Ah, mon cher comte. Comment allez-vous?
You are attending Anna Arkadyevna?
Yes. I've been called in urgently. I'm afraid she's had a relapse. Hope to see you later.
I'm coming with you.
He would never have refused to come. He was so kind. He has eyes like Sergei. That's why I dared not look him in the face, because he has Sergei's eyes. Sergei had his supper. You must not let him be frightened. Mariette must sleep in his room.
It is me, Anna. I have come.
His Excellency has just arrived. Madame Karenina has been asking for him continually since yesterday. She seems more peaceful since he returned.
When you are going to die.
Oh, no, no, Anna. You're not going to die.
What was I saying? How badly painted those flowers are. Not a bit like violets. Oh. Everything is confused again. It is so difficult. Oh, yes, yes. Yes, that's it. This is what I wanted to tell you. I am still the same as I used to be. The other woman in me, she fell in love. Oh, what weariness. Oh. No, wait. Wait. You don't know. I am myself again. I don't love him anymore. Alexei, there's only one thing I want. I want you to forgive me. To forgive me. Completely.
Alexei Alexandrovich.
I want you to listen carefully to what I have to say, so that you shall not misunderstand me. As you know, I had decided on a divorce and had even begun proceedings. I confess I was swayed by motives of revenge. More than that, when I heard of this illness, I even desired her death. But now I have seen her and forgiven her. And the joy of forgiveness has made my duty clear. I'm willing to offer the other cheek. This is my position. You may trample me in the mud, make me a laughing stock to the world. But if she lives, I shall not forsake her. Nor utter a word of reproach against you. If she wishes to see you, I will let you know. But now I think you had better go.
Oh, Hey, wait a minute, he's not quite dead, listen. Count Alexei Vronsky, captain of the horse guard, who had just resigned his commission, accidentally wounded himself while cleaning his revolver. The wound is serious, but his life is not in danger.
Do you believe it was an accident?
Isn't it logical in the case of a military man? I hand in my resignation. I am no longer an officer. I take my revolver to pieces. It's no use to me now. But the revolver wants to remain military, so it goes off. All that, the fault of that Anna Arkadyevna. All of them, their fate is sealed. And soon here she has drunk a bottle of laudanum by mistake while clearing out her liqueur cabinet. Alcohol at least kills you slowly.
Is that the Oblonsky's coat?
There you are, more of them.
Hello, my dear boy.
Nice to see you.
Working hard, eh?
What a surprise.
You'll stay, of course.
Well, that's very kind. But we just drove over to bring you that new saddle you asked for.
Oh, yes, thanks. You'll find it in the coach. I think you'll like it.
Yeah.
Go and see it.
Good morning.
Good morning, Konstantin Dmitrievich. I've done what no other girl in the world would do. Mother and father would die of shame on the spot.
I'm glad you came. I'm sorry about my hands. They're so dirty. We've been harvesting.
I knew you couldn't come back to me. I hurt you so much, so unjustly. And this morning when I read in the papers about Count Vronsky's accident, I felt so little about it that I realized then it was you I had always loved.
There's no need to say anything. I was waiting for you.
You know, Konstantin Dmitrievich, I really am very ashamed. Forgive me for all the pain.
That's all over now, Kitty.
I'm sorry you can't come to the wedding. Our presence together at this ceremony might have silenced a lot of malicious gossip.
I am sorry, too. Please tell Kitty from me that I hope she will be very happy.
Oh, I'm afraid I can't give that message. Such a remark might make it look as if there was some condescension on my part. You're forgetting Kitty's first engagement, which was broken off for reasons I needn't mention. You must be very circumspect in society.
As you wish. It is not important.
Good night, my dear. Try to get some sleep.
Sergei.
Yes, Mother?
Come along, quickly. We are late.
Sergei.
now.
Sergei, you are going without kissing me goodbye?
We're late, my dear. Sergei will kiss you when he comes back.
Goodbye, Mother. Sergei. Anushka.
Yes, madame.
Is everything ready?
Yes, madame. But madame is still very weak. She ought to rest a few days more.
I cannot bear it another moment.
Eternal, who unitest by an indissoluble bond those who are separate. Thou who didst bless Isaac and Rebekah and showest thy mercy to their descendants, bless now thy servant Constantine and Yekaterina and incline their hearts to good.
We saw on our first evening in Venice. You said it was like a palace.
Out of a fairy tale.
Yes. Well, it's ours.
Ours?
Ours. For as long as we want it.
That means until we die. Anna, you know all my thoughts. Let's go there now.
No, no. Just wait.
Then when shall we arrive?
My lover should. Yes, my darling, and we're nearly there. Look.
Anna. Then I shall order all the clocks in the world to stand still.
It's a little cold today, isn't it, Enrico?
Si, Eccellenza. 21st of September. Autumn. La signora è qui già da 3 mesi, eh?
Yes, 3 months already. Did the Count say when he would be back?
No, Eccellenza.
Scusi, signora. My little boy is coming. He has been at my sister's. But she is ill and she has sent him here. Would the signora permit him to stay?
But of course. How old is he?
8 years old, Eccellenza. I will see. Does not disturb you.
Oh, I like children.
Yeah, but he's such a little rascal.
I should very much like to meet him. You were never coming back.
I'm sorry. I was out walking and I quite forgot the time.
Shall we have dinner at the Daniele?
We've been there once already this week.
Well, then, let us go to the Giardino.
No, I think it's too cold. Let's stay here for a change.
Poor Alexei. You are getting a little bored with nothing to do.
Hmm? No, darling.
You remember you once told me you used to paint. Why don't you take it up again?
I'm afraid I'd never have the patience now.
Come in.
Scusi, signora. Here is the little rascal. Avanti, cammina. Vai dalla signora.
Io parlo molto male l'italiano. E tu mi comprendi?
Su, avanti. Parla, rispondi alla signora. Dove hai messo la lingua? Su.
Come ti chiami? Giuseppe. I think I'm going to like you very much, Giuseppe.
Andiamo, Giuseppe, lasciamo la signora.
Tell him he can come and see me whenever he likes.
Thank you, Eccellenza.
Look, the Russians. Hey, hey! What are they doing here? Anna, come.
I heard that part of the Russian fleet was anchored in the Adriatic.
Oh, why didn't you tell me? But their cavalry, look at their epaulets. Hey, hey! Look, I must go and speak to them. Do you mind, darling?
You want to very much, don't you, Alexei?
Shall I serve the coffee now, signora? Or will you wait for the count?
No, I won't wait any longer.
Va bene, signora.
Giuseppe! Giuseppe! Scusi, signora. Cosa fai qui? Ti ho proibito di disturbare la signora. Vieni. Don't be angry. Non cattivo con lei. He will be company for me. Vieni.
Oh, grazie, signora.
Vuoi un dolce?
Sì, signora. Grazie.
Lontano paese. Un piccolo ragazzo come te.
Perché non l'avete portata con voi?
Non era possibile.
Hello, darling. I'm a bit late. Yeah, what a day. I met two old friends. They took me to the ship. They wouldn't let me refuse. Well, you know how it is. Toast to the Tsar, toast to Russia, a toast to the regiment, a toast to the Slavs. Well, you know how it is. As I thought, it's a troop transport. On board, there were the second dragoons and the... They're on their way to the Balkans. It's not war, not exactly. But the Turks are in an ugly mood. We're taking precautions. There may even be some fighting. You went to dine alone, didn't you, darling?
Yes, but a gentleman joined me for coffee.
Oh?
Giuseppe. Alexei, you know what I've been thinking tonight? We have been away a long time, and it has been very wonderful. But soon it will be winter, and Venice is sad in the winter. And then, I too would like to see Russia again. I know that you would rather stay here. But all the same, let us go. I'm so glad for him. He's worked so hard on the committee.
I quite agree.
The press have been expecting it.
Have they heard the news? Are they talking about it?
I don't know how she dare show her face in St. Petersburg.
Spoiled everything for me.
My dear, in such an ordeal, friendship is not enough. In love alone do we find true support. In the love that he bequeathed us, he will help and sustain you.
It was a time when I could have enjoyed these honors. Could have enjoyed sharing them. But now that I'm alone, utterly alone, crushed by the ridicule I know people feel, though they don't show it to me. And yet I don't know what I've done to deserve this. I've searched my conscience, but I can't find where I'm greatly to blame.
No, indeed. You have acted in a fine Christian spirit.
I'm most grateful for your sympathy.
My warmest congratulations, Alexei Alexandrovich.
Thank you, Princess.
I have a message for you. From Anna.
I was expecting it.
I haven't seen her, of course. I couldn't very well in the circumstances. I'm only a messenger.
What does she want from me?
She begs you to let her see her son.
I suppose I have no right to refuse.
You see no evil in anyone.
On the contrary, everything seems evil to me.
I am not condoning her actions. But I understand her natural feelings as a mother.
Well, there's a limit to everything. I can understand immorality, but I can't understand cruelty. How could she bring herself to open your wounds afresh?
It's not myself I'm thinking of so much as my son. It might lead to questions which it would be impossible to answer.
She had a spark of feeling left. You'd never have asked it.
I've made up my mind.
Stepan Arkadyevich, a word with you.
With pleasure, Alexei Alexandrovich. Excuse me, my dear. Important business.
You'll excuse me.
Have you reached a decision on that little matter I was asking you about?
What matter?
That vacant seat on the board of the mutual credit balance of the Crimea Railways. Should you happen to see from ask your word on my behalf...
It's quite another matter I wish to speak to you about. It concerns your sister, Anna.
Her situation is painful, I know. You may say she deserves it. But we as her relatives would be very grateful if you could do something to make her position a little easier.
What I was about to say is that I've received a request from Anna. I would be glad if you would inform her that her request is refused.
But a divorce has become a matter of life and death for her.
I'm not speaking of a divorce. Anna's life is now no concern of mine. I'm concerned merely to safeguard my child and my reputation, which I need for the uninterrupted pursuit of my career.
I'm sure you will be guided by the highest motives.
No one can say I've not acted according to Christian principles.
madame. Oh, madame.
I've come to see Sergei. I asked his father, but I couldn't wait for the answer.
Oh, but...
How is Sergei? Is he all right? How does he look? Is he eating well?
Yes, and he's growing so fast.
How tall is he?
He comes up to here.
Already? Harriet, I must see him. Let me in. No one will see me.
Well, it isn't the same porter, and His Excellency has guests.
But I must see him.
And that's not the worst. His Excellency told us to say... You were dead. Guests are beginning to leave. Come tomorrow, very early, before His Excellency is awake. I'll let you in.
What is it?
I have come on behalf of Prince Karadumov to see Sergei Alexeyevich.
He's not up yet. He's still asleep.
It's all right, Kapitonich. Come in, madame, but you'll have to be quick.
Madame. It's against my orders.
Dared you tell the child that his mother was dead?
What should I have told him? That she had run away with her lover? I could only conclude that the kind of life you have chosen has affected your principles.
Alexey Alexandrovich, will you consent to a divorce? I no longer ask for my child. I beseech you to give me this last chance of happiness.
It seems to me that you have everything you yourself have desired.
Will you consent? You surely cannot refuse me.
I cannot act against my religious convictions. I consider the matter closed.
Is your appalling lack of discretion. I suppose the scandal you are causing is a matter of complete indifference to you.
No, of course it isn't, Mother. But don't you see, if you would accept Anna as a friend,
see her occasionally. You might stop that scandal.
Please understand, I cannot do it. My daughters are growing up. I have to move in society for my husband's sake. I cannot ask her to my home.
She's no worse than hundreds of people you do receive. And you were the first to find her charming.
As a traveling companion, yes. But not as my son's mistress.
In the eyes of God, she's my wife.
Let's call things by their proper names.
I'm sorry, I didn't know that.
I was on the point of leaving. Goodbye, my dear son. I know the way out. Goodbye, Anna Arkadyevna.
Did you have a pleasant day? Tell me where you've been.
What was your mother doing here? Trying to take you away from me?
No, Anna, please.
She's like the rest of them with their hands full of mud.
Anna, I beg you, don't speak like that about my mother.
Oh, I assure you, it is a matter of complete indifference to me what your mother thinks, or whom she wants you to marry.
Marry?
I've heard about the little Princess Sorokin.
Anna, what's the matter with you?
I feel I cannot go on living like this any longer, hiding from everyone. Alexei, let us go to the opera tonight.
Well, you know that's out of the question.
Why?
Well, as a matter of fact, I shall have to go. My mother has asked me to meet her there. But you know why we cannot go there together.
I don't want to know. What other people may say or think is unimportant. We love each other and nothing else should matter. Why can't we go?
But don't you understand that...
No, I don't understand. All right, go with your mother. I shall go alone. No, not alone. Natalia will be delighted to come with me. And if she can't, I'm sure there are plenty of people who will.
Alexei, our little Princess Sorokin is talking to you.
Oh, I beg your pardon, Princess. Yes, Madame Patty has a very beautiful voice.
He's lost to you and lost to me as well.
It's your fault, all yours.
I told you not to come, and I knew it would be unpleasant.
It was pleasant. As long as I live, I shall never forget it. It was hideous. She said it was a disgrace to have to sit beside me.
Just the words of a stupid woman. Why let them distress you?
It is you who put me in this intolerable position. You have brought me to this.
I've always known we must never risk insult, never provoke it.
You say we, but you mean me. You are free to go among your friends. It is I who must stay in the shadows.
Do I behave as if I were free?
In other words, you are a prisoner.
You are doing your best to create a prison for us both.
So you think it is a prison?
You goad me into saying things with this insane desire for strife.
Oh, if only you knew what it is when I feel you are hostile towards me. If only you knew how near I am to calamity, how afraid I am, afraid of myself.
Lucy. You haven't changed towards me, have you?
Amanda, you know my feelings for you can never change. But my dearest, you must write to Karenin and ask him for a divorce. What is it?
I'm sure that he will refuse.
No, he will not refuse. He will accept. And then we can go together wherever we please, get married and live.
It's all right. All right, I will write to him. But I would rather not wait for his answer in St. Petersburg. There is nothing to keep us here anymore. Nothing. Let us go to Moscow.
All right, my darling. Whenever you please.
Tomorrow, then. Tomorrow. Oh, forgive me for being so thoughtless, selfish, wretched. I love you, Alex. I love you.
This is the best I can offer, Your Excellency. Moscow is terribly overcrowded. This telegram came for Your Excellency.
Thank you.
Who is it from?
What?
The telegram.
Oh, it's from my mother.
Oh. What does she say?
She wants me to return to St. Petersburg to settle something about the estate.
But we've only just left. It's an excuse. I know that if you go to St. Petersburg, you will not come back.
Do be reasonable. It's purely a business matter. A couple of days at the most.
All right, leave me. Go to St. Petersburg if you want to. We are not chained together.
Anna, what's all this about? It's only the uncertainty of your position that makes you suspicious.
Uncertainty? What do you mean? I'm completely in your power. What is uncertain about that?
Anna, darling, as soon as we hear about the divorce, we'll get married, and then you won't have to torture yourself any longer.
Don't talk to me about the divorce. I've decided not to let it influence my life anymore. Why should you care about it?
Haven't you written to Karenin?
No.
Why? Why, Anna?
If he agreed to a divorce, you would feel forced to marry me. I don't want to impose that sort of obligation on you, especially now.
Now?
When there is this conspiracy afoot between yourself and your mother.
What conspiracy in heaven's name?
That you should marry the Princess Sorokin.
It's too ridiculous even for argument. I refuse to argue with you. We want a divorce. We need it desperately.
Need it? Why has it suddenly become so necessary?
Either you know as well as I do. It goes on and on. I want you to know this. I absolutely refuse to take any part in these arguments again.
Princess Oblonsky visit us?
Yes, milady. Prince and Princess Shevetsky and Mr. and Mrs. Levin are here.
then I...
Anna! How nice to see you.
I'm sorry, I didn't know you had visitors. I won't disturb you.
But it's only Kitty and the family. Of course you must stay.
No, I'd rather not see anyone just now. Besides, they wouldn't want to see me.
Anna, is anything wrong? You look so strange.
Dolly, I had to come and see someone, and you were the only person. You don't despise me and condemn me too, do you?
My dear, I love you, and I always will. Surely he loves you too.
I don't know. I worry about it night and day. Sometimes I think I'm losing him, that we're being irresistibly driven apart. Dolly, I daren't tell him that I've been to see my husband, and that he's refused me a divorce.
Then you can't get married.
Oh, you needn't worry. I won't ask you to receive me.
Oh, you know that you'll always be welcome in my house. It's Kitty's baby. Do come and see him. He's a wonderful little boy. There's a revolution going on upstairs. You'd think it was the first baby to be born in the world.
Kitty must hate me.
Oh, I know she doesn't. And she'd be so hurt if you didn't go and see her. Please, Anna.
Careful.
Careful.
Young man, this is not the first time I've had a baby.
Look who's come to see you. Anna.
Aunt Anna.
Ivan. It's right, Ivan, darling. Run along now.
Dear, Dolly asked me to come to see you. But if you'd rather I went away, you needn't be afraid to say so. I'm quite used to it.
But Anna, Constantine and I have you to thank for everything. Look, isn't he wonderful? No one's ever had such a baby. Feel his weight. Isn't he heavy?
Yes, it's time, madam.
Oh, yes, sir. Run along, children. Outside. Along. Go and play.
Come on,
no, 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 no.
Hungry. Will the gentleman please go over there?
Come along, Constantine.
All right.
Go down. We do the pillars.
You're not too tired after all these people.
Quiet, children. Recreation is over. Your tutor is waiting.
Vronsky's downstairs. Were you expecting him?
No.
Oh, ask him.
Don't tell him that I'm here.
Hmm? All right.
How are you, my dear Vronsky?
Very well, thank you. I'm sorry to disturb you.
Anything I can do for you? Sit down.
Thank you. Well, as a matter of fact, I've come to ask your help. I want you to persuade Anna to ask for a divorce. I can't speak to her about it myself. It only irritates her. Oh, I know how painful it is for her, but it's only a question of writing to Karenin.
It's very embarrassing. I've already seen Karenin and received his refusal. And so I understand, has she.
What? Oh, I didn't know. Well, in that case, I apologize for having asked you.
I'm sorry, I can't help you more.
Believe me, we're all very sorry for her. My wife was saying only yesterday that, excuse me.
Why are you here?
I think it's you who owe me an explanation.
What do you mean?
You had no need to conceal from me that you'd seen your husband.
Well, now you are free to leave me, as I know you intend doing.
Anna, why do you say these dreadful things? You're completely overwrought.
You said yourself it was impossible to go on living like this. If you no longer love me, it'd be more honorable to say so. Why do you lie to me?
Anna, don't try my patience. It has its limits.
What do you mean by that?
I've done everything you've ever asked me. And now you accuse me of telling lies and being dishonorable.
A man who reproaches me and tells me he's given up everything for me is dishonorable.
Tell me what you want of me.
I want your love. A
but it is gone.
Anna, that's not true. It's not true. But if you're determined to punish yourself, there's nothing I can do about it.
You'll be sorry.
Gone to St. Petersburg. I shall return within 2 days. I have gone to St. Petersburg. I shall return within 2 days. But he will not. He will never return. It's over. I shall never see him again. He will marry the Sorokin girl. His mother will force him to. He will laugh about me. And follow him. Punish him. I will escape from him. And from myself.
I beg your pardon, madam. I saw the door open.
You startled me. Is there a night train to St. Petersburg?
Yes, madam. There is one in half an hour.
Please order a carriage immediately.
Very good, madam.
Going somewhere. Why do they trouble? You can't escape from yourself. Sergei, I thought I loved him. Myself, I really loved. Exchanged him for another love. I could live without him. And there's nothing more to be seen. I must tell him that it will amuse him. Oh, of course. He won't be there for me to tell him about anything. Anymore. What station is this?
Glynn, madame. A few minutes to take in water.
Thank you. Glynn. I must go out. What a breath of air. I loved him more and more. Selfish. He loved me less and less. Freedom, he wanted. Nothing can change either of us. Too late. Forget. No, can I?